Inflatable Oz here, Aaron Freddy Fredericks, and I am so happy to be back with you guys this week. Today, I need some new irons. It's been my 40th birthday, so I decided to spoil myself. Well, my wife also allowed me to spoil myself. So what I did is recently, I, for the first time ever, I've got myself fitted up and went into my local golf pro, Drummond Golf here in Oz, and they sized me up, checked out my swing, all that sort of thing, said I was awesome, naturally, and then basically gave me four different sets of irons to try. First thing I noticed with all four sets of irons is how much heavier the head was and how much whippier the shaft was. My G25s that I'm currently playing at the moment, about probably 6-7 years old in terms of about 4 or 5 series of pings ago. So I was interested to see how the new pings would go. I tried the Cobra Speed Zones, which I'll tell you a little bit. I tried the TaylorMade Sim Max, and I also tried the Wilson D7s. All of them were much heavier in the head. You can notice that the second you can pick it up, how much heavier in the head is, like I was just saying. The ping, which I was using before, was again heavier as well. And the Cobra Speed Zone actually had, basically they removed a bit of weight from the top of the head and put a carbon fiber insert in. Basically, they're all trying to get weight lower to help create flight up. And obviously they also want to create less slice. I found these, both of these irons went about 5 meters further than my current G25s. The TaylorMade Sim Max and the Wilson D7, both good looking clubs. I noticed from the first two to the second two that they actually, you can see on the TaylorMade and the Wilson, they just looked thicker at the bottom of the head on the 7-iron. You can see it just, it looked like it sat on the ground more sturdily. Both of those ones went about 10 meters further than my current 7-iron. So that's quite crazy. What I discovered though is they're all just basically decreasing the loft as well. Each of them was at least 2 degrees, less lofted than my current one. And the big problem I've got with them constantly doing that is I'm not so much worried about distance, because if your 7-iron doesn't go 150, well, you've got a 6-iron to go 150. Why do golf makers think this is so important to us? You're probably wondering, which one did I settle on? I did just say that I'm not worried about distance, but I was also worried about confidence. The TaylorMade and the Wilson both gave a confidence behind the ball. They were solid, they were easy to hit. If you want to know about the technology, you could read about it, but essentially, this is what the technology of every club maker is trying to do. More forgiving, more distance. That's essentially it. You know, how they do it with their speed zone, their high impact, their sweet spots, whatever they want to call it, they're all doing the same thing. I settled at the end of the day, the TaylorMade was $230 an iron, the Wilson $130. Essentially, I felt exactly the same in both of them, and I am not about ego, I'm about a bargain. So do you know what I went? I went the Wilson. And I'm actually pretty happy about that, because as you know, I've used Wilson over time and I like that it's a little bit eccentric, it's a little bit different. Everyone can buy TaylorMade, and the more I go out there, I see full sets of TaylorMade, no one having a real crack at anything but the big boy. So anyway, I've gone the Wilson. You guys should definitely give it a try. It's so worth it. It's so much easier to hit. It just seems like it's got a draw bias. Trying to hit a fade is actually going to be a challenge. I've used them only a couple of times in the course, both times really good. The one biggest thing I noticed is I mishit an 8-iron into a par 3, and it still made the distance even though I mishit it. So that's really exciting. Big problem. Now, the pitching wedges are 2 degrees as well, stiffer or longer or flatter, which means it makes a bigger gap between my wedges. So I've actually had to buy a new thing called a UW. Listen, manufacturers, even though I'm happy with my Wilsons, you do not need to keep making the loft stronger. We know. It's like a set of jean makers, like, you know, the jean makers clothes. They're saying, oh, you used to be a 14, now you're a 10. It's the same size, they've just changed the label. We know if it's a 6-iron loft and you put a 7 on it, it's still a 6-iron. So just stop it. Get your technology involved. We will still buy them, and we don't need to hit a 7-iron longer than the one we just hit before. We're pretty happy with how low we hit them. Anyway, that's been my grumpy rant. I've brought the Wilsons. I really like them. Definitely worth a try, guys. This has been Mr. Land of Laws, Aaron Freddy Fredericks. You guys have a great week. And I'm going to let you know about my hybrids. So, anyway, catch you guys.